Tutorial, we are going to discuss how we can edit the Charles-Proxy response from the any request. Okay, so here we have an example request, API user 2. So we are just hitting this and getting the response. So before intercepting or editing the response, we have to make sure that once we are adding the breakpoints or we are rewriting the response, in the Charles-Proxy we can either use the rewrite function or rewrite method to edit the response, or we can put the breakpoints, and at the breakpoints we can intercept and edit the response. Either we can edit the response, or we can edit the response code, body, headers, URL, or whatever we want to intercept. So we can edit those ones. So first I'm going to tell you how we can use rewrite functionality to edit the response. Okay, so before moving, first we have to make sure that we have enable the SSL proxy. Okay, so what we can do here, just let's hit the response URL. Okay, so it will give you something like this. Why? Because if you look here, I have already added the SSL proxy. Okay, so if you go here and we can go to the SSL proxy settings, and if you look here, already SSL proxies is enabled. Okay, so I will do this. I will say okay, let's proceed. So now I can see this response here. Okay, and even though I can see this one, why? Because if you look here, add to, so we have user this one. Okay, and we can even though go to the content and see the response here. Otherwise, if we will not edit this, we will not be able to see the response in readable format. For example, if I'm going to just disable this, and how it will look, I'm going to disable. Okay, now I'm just going to refresh this. So if you look here, now it is refreshed, but I can see the new response here. This is unknown. If you look here, we cannot read this. Okay, so for this we need to add this one. So I'm going to add this point to enable the SSL proxy. Okay, so now this an SSL proxy is enabled. Okay, so our next step is to rewrite the response. Okay, so we will click on the tool, and inside the tools we can see here rewrite option. Okay, so this is the rewrite. So once we will click the rewrite, for example, I'm going to copy this one. So I'm going to enable this. I'm going to add new one. So I will say okay, this is the user API. So we will go here, we will put the scheme HTTPS. This is the host. I'm just keeping the port empty, so default one. So I'll just click here and automatically API, this is the path. So for the query, if we have any query parameters, we can use those query parameter. Otherwise we can, or if we are expecting that at the sometime someone can add the query parameter, then we will use the wildcard, which is a static. But right now I'm just keeping it open or empty. Why? Because I am not going to add any query parameters. Okay, so now this is the important area where if you look on the my cursor, so we have to add the rules here. So what we will do here, so first of all we have to select the type, which type of the response we are going to rewrite. For example, are we going to add new headers, are we going to modify the headers, are removing the headers, either we can change the host, path, URL, are we are going to add new query parameters, modify query parameters, are we going to remove the query parameter, or just we are going to change the response status. But here I'm going to tell you how we can change the whole body. So I'm going to select the whole body. So the important thing is we have to accept the response. Okay, so we have to check box the response. Okay, so here if you look, replace first or replace all. So I'm going to select replace all. Why? Because I'm going to edit the whole response. For example, so why this is important, this is useful, why? Because sometimes you are using the mock server, and in the mock server you are not getting the real response. So you have to just put the endpoint, and then you can send your own response. Okay, so here I'm just going to send the new information. For example, name is Imran. Okay, so make sure we have enabled the response. Okay, so replace R. So I'm going to click OK and then going to save. So now what we are expecting when we will hit this API, we are expecting a new edited response. Okay, so let's move on. Okay, so if you know this is why is that, because we have enabled the SSL proxy. Okay, so now we are going to proceed this and we should see the edit response here. So even though we can also check this response here in the proxy, for example, look at this two. This is the two is the latest one. Okay, so you can see the response here. Okay, so the next step is how we can put the breakpoints and then we can intercept the response. Okay, so now we are going to I'm just going to remove the whole one, this rewrite rule, because we are now using the other way. Okay, so I'm just double clicking and just making sure that I'm removing everything here. And even though I'm going to disable this one and now press OK. So now just for the testing purpose, if I would ask you to refresh, and if we will refresh, we can see here the previous response, the old one. Okay, now let's put a breakpoint. So we can put the breakpoint here, for example, on this. So there should be the breakpoint. Yes, this is the breakpoint. Okay, so now what we can do, we will just go here, we will edit the breakpoints. Why? Because sometime scheme, if you look here, scheme is not valid because this our API is. Okay, so we will put this, even though you can put empty, keep the empty port. So the same way we are going to request and response. Okay, I'm going to click OK, save this. So now what will happen, just observe the area. Okay, so once I will refresh this. Okay, so now if you look here, this is the one place. Okay, so now I'm going to here, this is the, if you remember, we put we enable two checkboxes, one for the request and other one for the response. Okay, so now this request is in progress, I mean we are going to send the request. So here we can change the request. If we want to edit this, we can edit this. I mean, for example, we can send 2, 3, 4, 5 or whatever, or we can add more values, but we are not going to change the request when we are going to send. Okay, so we are just going to, I mean I'm just clicking the execute. Okay, now our my request is sent. Now it's coming back. So if I will click here on the edit response and on the JSON, so I can see this one. Okay, for example, data ID is 2. So now I'm going to edit this one. For example, I'm going to put ID is 4 and first name is Muhammad and last name is Imran, for example. Okay, so now I'm going to, if you look, just for you sure, if you look here, it is request is in progress. Okay, so here this is the old one. So I'm just clicking on the execute button. So I'm just doing this. Okay, now execute button is clicked. So can you see here, ID is 4 and first name is Muhammad and last name is Imran. So even though we have the updated response here, the last one, the recent one. Okay, so you can see 4 and Muhammad Imran. So this is the way how we can edit the response. Okay, so we discussed two ways. One was using the rewrite and the other one was using the breakpoint. Okay, thank you.